Hello guys, today we are going to make a color switching game in Unity 5. Our wall can only pass with the same color like this. And whenever we reach to our color changing knob, the color will be randomized like that. This game is very helpful and hope you will like it. Okay, so now let's get started. I'm going to start Unity 5.6. Just create a new project. Name it color switch. Again, choose 2D project for it. Okay, so start with creating a 2D sprite. Name it player and choose an object and make it blue white.
Okay.
Just reset the transform and make it little bigger. So here it is. And now I'm going to switch the platform. Choose Android and click on switch platform button. Let's first, and you can adjust the screen size from here, so it's a portrait. Let's see. Now let's start with apply a circle collider 2D. Adjust the size of collider according to our knob or player, and don't forget to check in the trigger button, trigger checkbox, and now we need to apply a rigid body 2D unit. Just increase the grip scale to 3 and we save this scene file. I name it main. Okay, so now we need to create a jump function on click. Okay, so just add a new script, name it layer. Open it in MonoDevelop. Okay, so here we are. I'm going to delete all this. Just create a public float. Name it jump force. Equal to kf. And we need a public rigid body 2D. D2D, name it Army. Okay, now we need to create an update function. If input dot get with a node. Input dot get mouse button down 0 button 0 for left click, 1 for middle click, and 2 for right click. Okay, so rv dot velocity is equal to vector 2 dot up into jump force. Okay, so I think our jump function is created. So now Let me check.
Okay.
It will not work because we need to assign the read body to be here. Okay, so now we can check it. Okay, it is working fine. You can see it. We can also make jump by space. Okay, so now we need to create a ring. Okay, so I already made the ring by using Photoshop. Now I'm going to import it in Unity. Okay, so now select the ring sprite and sprite move. Select to multiple and add it back. This is very important part of this tutorial. So please select part of this ring according to color. Now we need to choose a center or pivot. So pivot of every sprite should be in center. So now we select to top right to this and bottom right, bottom left, and also top left. Okay, click on a button and then cut this window. Now we can see we have a part of this ring. Okay, so if we select all this and make reset transform, the ring will be automatically positioned on the correct position. So now we need to name it according to color. Circle green, circle blue, circle blue. Now we need to create an empty object. Name it small ring and select all this part and drag and drop to a small ring. Okay, now select all this part and apply the polygon collider tool. Okay, no need to do other thing. And now we are going to create some text red, yellow, blue, and green. Okay, so apply this text on same color ring. Red, this one is green, and yellow, and blue. Now we need to create a script for rotating this. So create our small ring object and apply the script rotate. Create a new script rotate. Okay, just open it in our mono developer. Okay, so now float speed auto underf void update Code is pretty fine for me to check. We need to check it. Okay, the pivot is not from correct position. This here. We need to create a color randomizer for every time we start the game, the ball should be with a different color. Okay, so now open player script and just create public sprite render. Public sprite render is and set random. Okay. So now we need to create this method. This method. Equal to now we need to create random for it 0 to 4, because for integer the maximum value will be not inclusive in this random. We forgot to create some colors. Probably color. Color red. Another public color. Color blue. Yellow, red colors, color blue. Okay, so yes, I got color chip color blue. Color red. Here we need to break. This one. Yes, color red. Color blue. Color yellow. And one power to break it. Okay, and now I think everything is fine. Now we need to select our player script and there is something here. I use colon instead of semicolon. Okay, one more. We need to pick color for our wall and below yellow and green. Now we need also need to assign a sprite render. Sprite render here, and please don't forget to set alpha to 255. Otherwise, your wall will be invisible or transparent. It is now. We can check it, and there it is. Currently, our wall is yellow, and now we restarted. And the wall is green. Now we again restarted. Okay, again green. Now our wall is red. Okay. So now we move forward. Now we should work on coalition two of our different color. So please don't forget to assign tag on different color. Like we assign it, we already assigned it green, yellow, and blue. So now create our own trigger. We need to create trigger enter, but first of all we need to create a public string. Public string correct color. Okay, so now one more looking to send it here. Current is equal to red, and now we copy this and paste it here. And here, and also add it to the yellow. Below and green. Okay, so now we create a server internal. On server internal 2D, because we are using 2D format. And also collider 2D. If depth is not equal to current color, then divide log check it. And when we think so, also it's not working. Okay, we need to check it. Okay, here it's only using now our game should be over. Okay, it's working. You can see our log show game over because we are rapidly colliding with different color. Okay, so now we need to a smooth camera follow. Select camera, add component, new script, camera follow. Just open it in mono develop. Just develop this and also this. Create a public transform and player. Create a state method. Now we need to check the Y position of our player. So if player dot position dot Y is greater than transform dot position dot Y, meaning our dot Y position, then transform dot position should be equal to new vector 3. We are going to use vector 3 and then transform dot position dot x. And now we place our position of y to player position. Transform the position dot v. Okay, I think this it should be working. Okay, I forgot to assign a player. let's stop it. Select the camera and drag and drop our player here. Okay. Our camera is moving smoothly with the player, but it is only one way. Okay, so now we need to create a color changing position. So just create a 2D sprite and select a new layer and make it with different color. And here we need to reset the transform of our length. Change and reset the transform, make it a little bigger. Move to correct position. Okay, and create a new tab. Color changer. Okay. And assign to our color changing object and also add a circle collider 2D. Okay, so now we need to edit our player script. Controller and my method. Also run the return function. So it is now below. Yes, it is working fine. Okay, so now I'm also going to create a function that will restart our scene when we collide with different color. Can copy this. Sorry, this. This and press Ctrl D for duplicate. You can also set the speed for different ring. Something like that, to double it. Then triple it and then off. Okay, so now we can run this game. Ok, Okay. You can see the game working fine. Okay. I cannot win this game, I think. It's very difficult to pass through the same color. Okay, I'm not a professional gamer. Thank you for watching my tutorial. Hope you like it. Please subscribe my channel and share this video to others. Thank you. Thank you so much.